أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، اتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، respected brothers and sisters, elders, we are still talking about preparation for Ramadan. And we said today like three points we discussed in our khutbah. The first point is that don't forget that special du'as that the Prophet ﷺ used to say in Ramadan, at the beginning of the month and during Ramadan. And the second point we've discussed is express your happiness and be thankful towards Allah that He helped you reach Ramadan. And the third point, which is the most important one, is what? Do you remember it? Like the third point was, you forgot, like it's educate yourself and your family about the rules of siyam. Remember now, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this gathering to gather us all also in the Jannah with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you're just behind the masjid, it's full, alhamdulillah, the masjid is full. Allahumma alhamdulillah, I ask Allah to gather us all in the Jannah, Allahumma ameen. Tonight, inshallah, we're still talking about the rulings of siyam, which you have to keep in mind, try to learn them and to teach your family. Our lesson today is about acts that are permissible during the fast. And my halaqah tonight is just some questions I will ask and you will try to answer. I will try to get the answers from you. If you don't know the answers, we will try together to get the answers, inshallah. And these acts which are permissible during fast, some people think they are disliked or they break your fast, they void your fast, but actually they are not. And we have a big difference between al-hukm and al-fatwa. Al-hukm huwa khitabu al-shari' azza wa jal al-muta'allaqu bi-ahkam al-ibad alladhi fihi nassun qat'i. يعني if you asked me a question and my answer was قال الله or قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, it means it's a hukm which never be changed except under the state of necessity. But if you ask a question and I don't give you an ayah or a hadith from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it means it's a fatwa. It depends on your case, who you are and where you live and whom you deal with and the circumstances you're dealing with. The acts today, the first question inshallah is pouring water over oneself and submerging oneself in water. Does it break your fast or not? Like if you're fasting and you take a shower because it's too hot today, I can't bear fasting the whole day, it is too hot. I will continue until another time, but I will go to take a shower, I will put some water on my head just because it's very, very hot. Do you think this action void your fast or not? What do you think?
No.
It doesn't void your fasting. We have here a narration reported by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Imam Malik and Abi Dawood, and it's an authentic narration. And Abi Bakr ibn Abdul Rahman radiallahu anhu reported from a number of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had seen Allah's messenger pour water over his head while he was fasting due to thirst or extreme heat. Alayhi salatu wa sallam. So even you only take a shower to clean your body, you even take a shower because it's too hot outside. That's also permissible. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do that. Imagine now you're taking a shower while fasting and you swallowed some water. Some water came into your stomach, like you swallowed some water. Would that action void your fasting or not?
Inside,
yeah, you drank some, yeah. Actually drank some water, so it breaks your fast?
Yeah, obviously.
If you didn't intentionally.
Yeah, thank you. That is the answer. So if you do that intentionally, like imagine that you're going to take a shower and say, subhanAllah, it's too hot, but you are very thirsty. You're going to drink water, but people do not, right? No one noticed that. You're just drinking. So now you brought your fast, right? And it's between you and Allah. But if it is unintentionally, you're swimming, for example, diving into the water and you're fasting, and you drank a lot of water, but unintentional, but a lot of water. What do you think?
No.
It doesn't break your fast. Because in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Surah Al-Ahzab, وَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ فِيمَا أَخْطَأْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَكِنْ مَا تَعَمَّدَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ. Whatever you do by mistake, you'll never be questioned. You'll never be asking about Allah about it. Because it's by mistake. And take the qa'idah in your life. Always you have this qa'idah. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, رُفِعَ عَنْ أُمَّتِي الْخَطَأُ وَالنِّسْيَانُ وَمَسْتِكْرُهُ عَلَيْهِ. Whatever you do by mistake, or you just forgot something, you forgot to pray, you forgot to fast, just forgot. Plus you're a human being. Or whatever you have done by force, someone forced you to commit a sin, so you will not be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to this hadith. The second point, applying kuhl or eye drops or anything else to your eyes, does this break your fast or not?
Yes.
It breaks your fast?
Yeah, obviously. No. Go inside, right?
No.
Into your body. No. It's a medicine, that's why it's no.
You know, that's exactly the difference between hukm and fatwa. If we have an ayah or a hadith, I will say, قال الله قال رسول الله خلاص. No discussion, we will all obey and we will just listen and obey. But here, we don't have a specific evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why the scholars like you have differed concerning this. These acts are all permissible, even if some taste from it finds its way to the throat. Why? Even if you got some eye drops, use it to your eyes, and you feel its taste in your throat, it doesn't break your fast. Because of what? Because the eyes are not the passageway to the stomach. It's not the normal way. When you want, if you want to eat, you eat from your eyes or from your ears or from your nose. Of course, if your mouth, right? That's why. So whatever goes to your stomach, if you feel the taste in your throat while you put something in your eyes, it doesn't break your fast because it's not the normal, it's not the usual way, the normal passageway to your stomach. That's it. And among the Sahaba we had Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, and we said before his job he was the servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 9 years. Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik, it's reported that he would apply kuhl while he was fasting radiallahu anhu. This opinion is the opinion of Imam al-Shafi'i and Sayyidina Abu Hanifa and al-Hasan and al-Thawri and Abu Dawood and others. And according to Imam al-Tirmidhi, nothing authentic has been related from the Prophet concerning this question. So we don't have specific narration. That's why it's not a hukm, it's not rule, it's a fatwa. Another question. Kissing, while fasting, does it break your fast?
Yeah.
Thank you. Kissing your children, does it break your fast?
No.
Kissing your wife does it break your fast?
Yeah, breaking.
Kissing your brother in Islam does it break your fast?
No.
Well, then, I mean, anyone else allowed to kiss, right? Allowed to kiss anyone else? Just your wife, your children, and your brother in Islam. Nothing else. And for existence, your sister in Islam. But here, kissing, because it's a fatwa, see what happened. And Nabi alayhi sallam, he was sitting in a halaqa like this. And a man came and said, سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن التقبيل والصائم يا رسول الله am I allowed to kiss my wife while I'm fasting? النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said yes, you are allowed. And another man, he came in the same gathering and asked the same question, but the Prophet gave him a different answer. Am I allowed to kiss my wife while fasting? He said no, عليه الصلاة والسلام. So that's an old, I always mention that. Big difference between al-hukm and al-fatwa. Fatwa depends on your circumstances, in your age even, as you will see now. In the environment, in the country where you live, it's a fatwa. So the first one, I also said, you're not allowed to kiss, second you're allowed to kiss. قال سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه فنظرنا فإذا الأول شاب والثاني شيخ. Or al-awwal shaykh wa al-thani shaykh. The first questioner, he was an old man. That's why the Prophet allowed him, because he can't control himself if he kissed his wife. He wouldn't commit anything. Like he wouldn't practice marital relations with her, because he can't control himself. He's an old man. But the second one, he was a young man. He was strong. In most cases, he can't control his desires. That's why he prevented him. Of kissing someone. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab said, he said, هَجَشْتُ فَقَبَّلْتُ وَأَنَا صَاحِبٌ فَأَتَيْتُ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقلت يا رسول الله ارتكبت أمرا عظيما فقال ما هذا؟ قال قبلت وأنا صَاحِبٌ. Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه said, I was excited one time and I kissed my wife while I was fasting. I went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, today I committed a major sin. At that time you have to make a thought to free a slave or to fast 2 consecutive months or to feed 60 poor people, right? So he said, I committed a major sin. He said, what happened? He said, I was excited and I kissed my wife while fasting. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَرَأَيْتَ لَوْ تَمَطْمَطْتَ وَأَنْتَ صَائِمٌ. قال لا شيء. قال فيما السؤال إذا؟ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what do you think of rinsing your mouth with water while fasting? You're fasting and you make wudu. You're rinsing your mouth. Does it break your fast? Of course not. فقال سيدنا عمر, there is nothing wrong with that. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, then what is the question about? طيب. This is the opinion of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. That you can kiss your wife if you can control your desires. Because Imam Ahmad Hanbal is from Ahlul Hadith. People in Saudi Arabia, they follow them in most cases. And he's from Ahlul Hadith. He is Alim Hadith and scholar Hadith and Fiqh too. So we have some narrations, he depends on the narrations. But as for Sayyidina al-Imam Abu Hanifa, al-Imam Shafi'i, he says it is disliked to kiss while fasting if it incites your desires. Like if you can't control yourself, just skip it. Like all of them unanimously agree upon that. You are not allowed if you can't control yourself. تقول السيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقبل وهو صائم وكان أملك كل إبه. عائشة رضي الله عنها. عائشة is a woman, but she was among the scholars of the Sahaba. And they used to take knowledge from her. So if you see a woman or a girl serving you in public, do not criticize her just because she is a woman. As Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, she was one of the greatest scholars among the Sahaba of Rasulullah. Here is she said her opinion. She said, the Prophet would kiss and embrace while he was fasting. For he had the most control of all of you over his desires. كان رسول الله يحب الوصايا لكنه كان أملك كل إبه عليه الصلاة والسلام. Another thing, like cupping. Cupping. You know cupping? And hijama. Is it allowed while fasting? You're just taking some blood off your body. Does it break your fast?
Yes.
Why?
Because it's in your body, right? It's in your body, it's bigger off, right? That's what.
If you go to the washroom and you get something out,
yeah.
You're not getting something inside.
Yeah.
You get me? Like, cupping is you get some blood from your body.
Yeah, it's through your body, right? It's that breaks up your body, right? It blood is out. That's as you break. That's the main reason, right?
No.
It's not break.
So what?
It's not break.
No, it doesn't break the fast. Why? You have an erection here.
Listen.
No,
in my knowledge,
you
did not good, right?
That's okay. Your knowledge is very good. Allah Azim. MashaAllah. JazakAllah khair. What's your name?
Sayyidina.
BarakAllah khair. The best people in Regina are Sayyidina.
Come on,
man. Anyone who's been Sayyidina?
You're kidding me. Yeah.
One of the best people. ثابت ابن قيس البناني رضي الله عنه asked سيدنا أنس بن مالك the servant of Rasulullah, he said, did you dislike cupping for a fasting person during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Listen to the answer of سيدنا أنس, because answer of سيدنا أنس actually it could be no and it could be yes, and that's why the scholars have different opinions. He said, no, we did it, unless it made someone weak. Like if you make hujana and it makes you weak, now it is disliked. But otherwise, it is not disliked. In the opinion of Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu. طيب, rinsing the mouth and the nose. Anyways, if you heard from another scholar that it breaks your fast, you can follow this opinion, it's up to you. It's not a big deal. Sayyidina, rinsing your mouth while making wudu. It doesn't break your fast, we just mentioned that. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم للقيط ابن صبرة, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم للقيط ابن صبرة, وبالغ في المضمضة والاستنشاق إلا أن تكون صائما. Like, it is from the sunnah to exaggerate while rinsing your mouth and your nose when you make wudu to clean yourself, except if you're fasting. Because if you exaggerate while fasting, you will swallow some water and it's disliked. But if you swallow some water unintentionally, it still doesn't break your fast. But exaggerate except if you're fasting. That is something of a solution. We have some things which we can't protect yourself from, like swallowing one's saliva or the dust in the road. You can't protect yourself from that, so it doesn't break your fast. And these are the actions I wanted to mention tonight about fasting, which doesn't break your fast. Inshallah, if you have any question, we can answer them, but please write it down, we can answer them next time because we have to do the youth halakha, inshallah, now. It's too late for them. Next time, inshallah, we'll talk about the actions that break your fast. Jazakumullah alfu khair, subhanahu wa bihamdih. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.